Previously on Popular.
What's wrong?
Quit the musical and play at homecoming. Coach Peretti says that if we make a good show at the game...
You should be in the musical. You're the actor here, not me.
You would have someone to blame for your problems when your problem, Sam, is yourself. Now that you've ended cheerleaders and my relationship with my boyfriend, maybe you can find some time to grab some therapy. You need it.
A wind advisory is in effect until the end of this week for all viewing areas. The havoc-wreaking Santa Ana winds are traditionally accompanied by a general feeling of chaos, confusion, and unexpected romantic entanglements. Those in the way of the winds are advised to protect themselves by wearing windbreakers and chastity belts.
Is this the first musical you've directed, Miss Ross? And if so, how do you intend to invest it with your vision?
I don't have a vision. I have a mortgage.
So you're saying you took on this assignment solely for the cash?
Look, I know what went down with you and my predecessor.
I never asked Mr. Vincent to
do it. Sam, I like you. You got spunk. But I also like my dental plan. You twist my words, I lose my job. Next thing I know, I'm giving myself a root canal with a rusty screwdriver. Gina, is Josh Ford here yet?
I'm here.
You're late. Prioritize, Mr. Ford.
Sorry.
Gina, where are my other actors?
Oh, Grossman.
I need another body on stage.
Oh, I only came to do the article.
Cokie Roberts did not ascend to great heights because she was afraid of Ted Koppel's chair. Go, now, hurry. Thank you. Sit on your stump, Mr. Ford.
What stump?
The one in your imagination. Use the chair.
Well, who's she playing?
Your daughter, who you love and adore and will be sitting on your right knee.
Okay. I really need to get ready for class.
So do I, Cokie, so let's not waste precious time. Gina, give me a sunset.
Why are you here anyway?
I'm doing a feature for the paper.
Oh, great. You gonna try and get him to cut the drama budget, too?
You have a question, Mr. Ford?
Yeah. I was wondering what it means in the song when it says, with verve.
It means somebody should be clapping at the end besides your parents.
Right. No problem.
And?
Dites-moi.
Okay. Get back on the stump.
No, I can't. I've got to go. I'm sorry.
Twice will last the longest in this life. Character or rock hard fights. In the end, do you believe that beauty lies in what you see? Cause if you do, then baby, you've been deceived. Well, me.
When did this happen?
Like 2 minutes ago.
Okay, are you sure that it wasn't his keys or a fanny pack or a really big zipper?
Carmen, I was on his lap. It arose.
Wow. So do you think Josh is into you?
Are you insane? No, no, no.
No, I'm just saying if you're still looking for a way to make Brooke lie under a bus, then this was choice.
Carmen, this was a total accident.
Okay, but even if it was, I still think you should hang low for a while because Brooke and them are really freaking out about that editorial, and if she heard about this,
no,
she would...
No, she's not going to hear about this. Why would I say anything?
Yeah.
Right?
Right.
Okay.
Nick, it's been like 46 hours and Josh still won't speak to me. He thinks I'm this cold, heartless witch.
Oh, please, your heart's the size of a cantaloupe. However, you could work on the climate control.
What do you mean?
Let's face it, B. You're dial set on Tundra, and take it from me, sometimes it doesn't hurt to give off a little heat.
I give off heat? Don't I?
Sure you do. But if you want your honey to hit speed dial, you may want to lose a few accessories. Like your bra.
Wow. You and Josh, I mean, that is so toaster in the tub. But I could see it.
What? No, no, you can't. He's a walking steroid. I mean, I wouldn't touch him with a toilet brush. And besides, Josh Ford would never like... Come on, just promise me you won't say anything. Shh.
Brookie, if you need me to carry your underwear in my purse, it's not a problem. What are you looking at?
Come on, Carm.
Hurry, Carm. Madam Muckraker needs you to proofread her latest diatribe. Ooh, what'll it be this week, Mucky? Maybe you could go after the lunch lady with the hair lip because you ain't bringing the cheerleading squad down. The Mary Cherry Foundation has already stepped in to keep the glamazons in the style to which we are accustomed. Thank you.
Okay. What do you think? Any warmer?
You are a spherical miracle.
Great.
Okay, two ice cubes and we're in business.
Yeah. What, you want to toss in your opinion, too, or do I have to wait and read in the school paper?
Please, like she would know what turns a guy's head? Come on.
Now, you know it's in here.
I'll skip it. I'll just wear this.
Why this head and hat fetish?
Haircut victim.
Really? Can I see it?
Sure. When I'm a senior. Is that a uniform?
No.
And a hairnet?
Give it to me.
Whoa.
Harrison, give it to me.
Since when you start working at Mr. Cluck's?
Look it off. It's only temporary. They're the only place hiring. Got my mother off my back, okay? And I might be able to do some good there.
You've been boycotting poultry products since you had training.
Yeah, okay, your point.
Isn't working at a chicken shack just a little hypocritical?
No, not if I'm on the inside pushing side dishes. Norma Ray started out sweeping lint. Jeez, that is scary.
It's not that bad.
Harrison, nice haircut.
Okay, give me the cap. Now. Listen, about what happened in play practice.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Yeah, well, I think it should just be our secret, okay? Just between us.
Fine.
Now, you didn't tell anybody, did you?
No, no.
Thanks.
You will encounter this term frequently. Greek mythology is full of characters who make the mistake of angering the gods. Whenever a mortal dares to challenge the established hierarchy, he or she suffer for their hubris. Now, who can give me an example of a character who was punished for excessive pride? Miss Ferrara?
Yes. What was the question?
Miss Julian, can you help Miss Ferrara?
Not without a bucket of spackle. Just kidding, Carm. You know you rock my world.
Let's save the reconciliations for Mother Love, shall we? Anyone else?
What about Icarus?
What about him?
Well, he had a lot of that hubris. His daddy warned him not to fly too close to the sun, because that was territory reserved for the gods. But he paid Big Daddy no mind and ended up frying like a hush puppy.
Well, actually, his wings melted and he plunged into the sea. But thank you, Mary Cherry, for that Kentucky Fried twist. Any other examples? In many of their tales, the ancient Greeks tell us that arrogance is a dangerous trait. No matter how much power any mortal achieves, he or she will ultimately be humbled by something larger and much more powerful. In other words, you dare to strive with the gods, you will be destroyed.
Qu'est-ce que vous voulez say?
This is the language of romance. Do not butcher. Qu'est-ce que vous voulez say?
Qu'est-ce que vous voulez say?
Très bien, très bien. Now turn to the person on your left and practice the conversation.
Weird, huh? Twice in one day.
Bonjour, Pierre. Qu'est-ce que vous faites?
Omarie, quel bon surprise.
Montrez-moi cette photo, s'il vous plaît. Mais où est-ce?
Nous sommes chez nous en Nouvelle-Angleterre. Écoute, je ne peux pas contrôler mon appétit sexuel.
Es-tu désolé que c'est arrivé?
Ben non. Là, mieux que tu le sais. Plus tôt que plus tard.
Que je sais quoi?
Dur.
Hello?
What do you think you're doing? Why aren't you washing the breasts?
What?
I want those breasts squeaky clean.
This is Josh?
Isn't somebody here supposed to be on biscuit count?
I'm on break.
Your break ended 11 seconds ago. Or did we miss the part of orientation where we discussed breaks?
I already counted the biscuits. They're all there, okay?
Well, somebody parked the biscuit bin next to the grill. Would that be you?
I don't remember. Does it matter?
It does if you want to keep your biscuits soft and fluffy. Soft and fluffy is Mr. Cluck's way.
Listen, Lily, I promised I wouldn't say anything, and you have to swear this won't go any further. Miss Ross made Sam sit on Josh Ford's lap during rehearsal this morning, and JF sprung a major pup tent. At first, I thought Sam was exaggerating, but then I saw JF staring at her in class, and it wasn't an evil stare. It was more like, hey, you're the first person besides Cammy Diaz who's done that to me before 9 a.m. And the more I think about it, the more I wish Sam and Josh would get together. I mean, just to shake things up and, like, end this stupid war.
Obviously, his compass points in other directions, but Sam McPherson's not even on the map. Ooh, I gotta run. I'll meet you at the stairs.
How you doing, Brookie? I'm so sorry.
Look, even if everyone knows, no one's ever gonna believe it. Do you want me to run out and get you something? Like Xanax or Valium or Prozac? Well, but Prozac you have to take for like a week.
No, I don't need any Prozac, Nick. I'm fine. You know, I just need to be alone right now, okay?
You sure?
Yeah, I'm sure.
So then he turns to me and he says, "We handle our chicken parts with love and respect."
What a freak.
Total. He's had it in for me since the second I came through the door.
Why?
I don't know. Maybe because I don't have to sound out words while reading the Mr. Cluck's handbook. I swear, Sam, the chickens they're serving are smarter than the staff.
Okay. More important question, is there something hanging out of my nose?
No. Why?
Oh, my God.
What is that about?
Yo, Sam, want to check out my lab?
Did I miss something?
Hey.
Have you seen Carmen?
I think she's looking for you.
Yeah, I bet she is.
Did you not get the email?
No, I was busy reparking a biscuit bin. What the hell is going on?
Carmen? Wait. You have something you want to say to me? Because you can keep avoiding me, but we will have this conversation.
What do you want me to say, Brooke?
You know, Josh and I, we go back a long, long time, and we may fight now and then, but we do have an understanding. No matter how thirsty either one of us gets, we don't drink out of the toilet.
Maybe you should ask your friend Josh why he's so thirsty.
Does he know? Does he know I'm Linda Tripp?
Sam.
Turn around, Ferreira.
Sam, it was a total accident. I mean, I was never gonna send it. I wrote the email to myself and well, maybe Lily.
Turn around, Ferreira. The organism we studied last week is actually less evolved than the paramecium. If you read the chapter, you would know where exactly the paramecium falls on the food chain. You'd also know that the mature paramecium has much in common with the single cell amoeba.
As for cell replication, the paramecium will often divide into twos,
going?
Then three.
Hi.
Despite the pain, it feels nothing, much like my mother.
Pretty baby, I love your eyes, oh pretty baby.
Don't hide the dew. Looks good on us. By heating the solution, we're able to study the thermodynamic effects on the organism.
Miss Glass, sir, before we delve into the fascinating life of the paramecium, may I ask a biologically related question?
Shoot.
Is it possible for a male member of the species to control an erection, or is that strictly involuntary?
Which species are we inquiring about?
Well, mostly boys. Teenage boys.
The human male can experience a reflex erection or a spontaneous erection. The reflex usually results from direct stimulation of the genitalia. A spontaneous erection can be elicited by a psychogenic fantasy or other factors purely physiological. There are any number of variables that could make it very difficult to keep the bull in the barn. Now, can we get back to the paramecium?
Hey, Brooke, she left out the I can't help being a slut factor.
What the hell's going on back there?
Mary Cherry's burner just flared. Her eyebrows are gone. Awesome!
Oh my God! Am I blind? Why is everything so white?
Because you're staring at my lab coat. You're fine, Cherry. Just slightly singed. All right, people, back to work. Show's over.
Awesome.
I don't believe you.
I mean, why would she lie?
I don't know. Probably because she's the closest thing she's ever going to get to the real thing.
Whatever.
Look, maybe this whole thing happened because my hormones are on edge, okay?
Maybe your hormones are on edge because somebody wanted to be alone for a while.
Well, not anymore. Brooke, look at me.
What?
I want to be with you. I've always wanted to be with you. That's why I've waited.
Well, what do we do now?
I say we do it today. I'll come over straight after practice. We'll do it at 4:20. I've missed you, Brooke.
If you're into the shopping mode, allow me to introduce you to my new line of fashion accessories. Buttocks bolos.
Get those out of my face before I make you eat them.
Sorry.
Sorry's not gonna reconnect this head to those abs. Loser.
Oh,
Either you start talking or I start flushing.
But I only asked that question to protect Brooke. I wanted everyone to know that Josh's situation had nothing to do with who was on his lap. My grandmama told me that many men have that same reaction to a cinnamon bun. Besides, why would Josh crave some frigid little virgin when he's got Brooke?
Hey, Brookie.
Now look what you've done, Scarface. Hey, come on, Brookie. You know what? You can't let this crush you. I take everything LaToya says with a giant salt lick.
That's not what I'm upset about.
Then what is it? Are you and Josh really over?
Check back with me in 2 hours and 7 minutes.
What's happening then?
We're doing it.
Good.
For the first time.
Wait, what do you mean? You mean you and Josh have never... I have the day and time marked down on my file of facts.
I lied. I'm sorry.
Well, it's okay. Really?
Yeah.
Well, look, if you need, like, any pointers...
Recognize as Sam McPherson.
Well, I was gonna suggest me, but if you'd rather talk to Mary Tyler Hoare, that's okay, too.
So how pathetic would it be to say that I'm a little scared right now?
That's not pathetic.
Okay, Sugar D, you don't even deserve this tidbit, but I cherish you way too much to withhold. Secrets, that is. Josh and Brooke are virgins. It's true. They're virgins. Tell everybody.
Hey, is it okay if I sit with you guys?
I'm going outside.
Okay, Sam, you know, never mind. I'll sit over here.
It's gonna take a long time for this to go away, isn't it?
I'm beginning to see why the school only stocks plastic knives.
You don't have to defend me.
No, they weren't even talking about you. Mary Cherry just announced the Kennedys' king and queen are virgins. Well, I'm not even surprised. My Barbie and Ken were missing those important parts, too.
Brooke and Josh.
No way. Check it out, Carm.
Emery, those are disgusting. Please go away.
Well, Nicole doesn't think so. She just bought 2.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
So, at 4 o'clock, I'm going to be telling Coach that I'm going to be taking a makeup test. You got to back me up on this, okay, Sugar?
Whatever.
Hey, I'm not exactly lying. I mean, I am making something up. It's just with Brooke in the one subject where I excel. What? Oh, you guys all think I'm into Sam McPherson now. I can't believe this. You guys are acting like...
Dude, the only person acting here is you.
What?
Man, you want everybody to think you're the man? Go to a chat room. And stop dishing up sex tips when you've never even done it. So everybody knows the scoop about you and Brooke. You know, what's been going on, what's not going on. I'm not into covering for you anymore.
Can we just talk for a second?
Look, if we start talking, we're gonna be back in school tomorrow in the same situation. What, do they seal these things with crazy glue or what?
What situation? Did you tell your friends that we were doing this today?
Yeah, right. I put up signs, Brooke. What you all heard today is true, both J and B, the big V.
Wait, everybody knows? How? Who told them?
Not me.
Oh,
Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
What are you doing?
I'm calling Nicole's.
Call her later, Brooke.
Do you think that I can have sex when I have to deal with serious damage control?
I don't know.
Will you stop? This is not about you just rushing across some line to do a little dance in the end zone. Okay, just go. Just go. Come on. Get out.
Hi. Are you looking for somebody?
Brooke and I just had a huge fight. Can I come in?
Yeah. Yeah. Do you want to sit?
No, I'm not staying long.
Okay. So, how are you?
How am I? You ruined my life.
Okay.
No, this whole thing started because you couldn't keep one stupid secret.
I only told one person.
And how'd you know about me and Brooke, or what? Was that just a lucky guess?
That did not come from me. I didn't know.
Yeah, well, now you got a great story to follow your lead.
It's not a crime to be a virgin.
Yeah, not for you. People would expect that. Look, I didn't mean that. That didn't come out right.
Okay.
No, it's not. My life is just a total disaster right now. My parents, they're at each other's throats. My best friend thinks I'm a mega fraud. My girlfriend just kicked me out of her house.
Look, I'm really sorry.
Yeah. What's that doing here?
Oh, that's mine. I just brought it to show Mr. Grant some layout ideas.
Did you go to Ocean Park Elementary?
We were in the same class.
I don't remember you.
Yeah, well, we hung out in different crowds.
God, I haven't looked at this thing in like 2 years. Don't you ever wonder what happened to some of these people?
I see most of them every day.
Oh, yeah, right. No, I mean like the ones that moved away or teachers and stuff.
Welcome to Mr. Clock's. May I take your order?
I'm going to have a three-piece combo and a Super Saver lemonade.
Did you want chicken in that combo?
Isn't that what I'm getting pieces of?
Well, I could give you extra side dishes. There's coleslaw, spicy coleslaw, extra spicy coleslaw.
I want the chicken.
Okay, fine. As long as you're aware that most poultry is raised in dark, waste-ridden cages where it's force-fed hormones and antibiotics.
Excuse me, sir. Pilar, get this gentleman a TPC and SS lemon stat.
Yes, sir.
Can you speak to him, please? What are you doing?
Taking orders.
No, clearly that's the one thing you don't know how to do. Who the hell do you think you are?
An enlightened human being. If you want, I could bring in some literature.
No, I don't want. You were not hired to educate. You were hired to serve chicken.
There are other items on the menu.
Are served with chicken. Now, go apologize to that gentleman.
For what? Opening his eyes to the unchecked cruelties of the meatpacking industry?
You know what? Not only are you going to apologize, you're going to eat this while you apologize.
No, look, it's okay, really. I could probably use a little roughage anyhow.
I apologize, sir. The chicken here is very tasty.
Newsflash? This margarita mix? 48 grams per serving. I say we moisten our fingers in the tequila and then dip them into the pouch. Okay, honey. You've got to get a grip. If Josh Ford was dumb enough to trade down, then let the loser go. Let's toast to you finding yourself a dishy senior with a friend. Mm-hmm. Cheers. Mm-hmm. Come on, let's drink up.
Claudia Sills. Wow.
Didn't she, like, move to Michigan or something?
Yeah, lucky for me.
I thought you two were...
Well, we were. Until Stacy Brivick's 7 Minutes in Heaven party. You remember that?
I wasn't invited.
Came time for my 7 minutes, right? I was totally freaked. I mean, I started warming up, you know, practicing on her Snoopy pillow. I turned my head too fast, and Snoopy's ear gets caught on my braces. I was so ready to be a sixth grade dropout, you have no idea. What about you? Did stuff like that ever happen to you?
Yeah, all the time.
Yeah.
I remember once writing a poem to this boy I liked. My teacher found it and made me read it out loud and then tacked it up to the bulletin board.
Well, that's not so bad.
It was heinous. That poem was private. There was only one person I wanted to share it with.
So give it to him now.
Nah, I don't think so.
Well, you should. I mean, I bet he'd love it. Getting a poem from somebody, that's like deep. You know, in a weird way, that teacher did you a really huge favor. I mean, you are a really good writer. You know, and what if you just kept filling up all these notebooks and no one ever saw any of it?
I can't believe I lost both of the men in my life to these McPherson women.
Who are these people?
Total ESOCs.
ESOCs?
Mm-hmm.
What is that?
Eating Stouffer's out of the container.
Look up. And don't start crying again, because I ain't got nothing for Pep.
I'm not going to cry.
Okay, look over there.
Why is he staring at us?
Who?
Him.
Pull the shade, Pinhead!
Whatever.
You're so bad.
Hey, B, can I borrow your leather jacket? My arms were really fat.
Yes, of course you can.
Thanks, B.
Okay.
You look so passion, Barry.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
So do you.
Thank you.
Could you come down here, please? Look, I know you can hear me. Just come down. I want to ask you something. Please.
You don't need to send that.
Sam, God, you scared me.
Do you mind if I delete
this? No, don't. It is a retraction, and I am sending it to everyone who got the evil email.
Forget about it, okay? It's done. I just spent the last hour in the AV room with Josh Ford.
Oh, my God. This is all my fault. Are you ever going to forgive? You're never going to forgive me. What can I do? How about some new boots?
Or will you quit? I'm here to thank you.
Why?
Carm, everything happens for a reason, right? If you hadn't dropped that evil gummy worm, Josh Ford would have never stepped foot into that office. And you know what? He's not at all who we thought he was.
So, do you like him? I mean, does this mean that you and me here?
No, Carm, we just talked.
Wow. You're welcome.
You know what's going on, don't you?
I hear things.
Do you know where your friend Sam is right now? She's with Josh, my ex. She's been planning this for a while, hasn't she?
Planning what?
Do you find her attractive?
Sam? Yeah, I guess. I don't know. I don't really look at her that way.
What about me? Do you find me attractive? Come on, I asked you a question. Do you find me attractive? More attractive than Sam?
What have you guys been drinking?
Why can't you answer that?
I can. It's just...
What? Huh?
Sam's a good friend.
Yeah. Yeah, I know. Everybody loves Sam.
Oh, no. I don't feel so well.
Hey. What do you think you're doing?
Helping her walk.
When did you go from being a peeping Tom to a Boy Scout?
Right about the time your friend puked in a pricker bush.
Oh, even talking about Sam McPherson makes me hurl.
Maybe next time you want to play cocktail waitress, you'll let someone else mix the drinks, huh?
Listen, sweetheart, I've got to run. It's Mom's bridge night, and if I'm not home to scoop melon balls, I may lose Neiman Marcus privileges.
You plan on driving like that?
I guess not, officer friendly.
Wait, where's she going? You're not leaving, are you?
No, not if you don't want me to.
I don't want you to stay here. I don't feel good.
Hard as rock, you're solid as the ground.
I told you I'd be a few minutes late. Why are you so upset? What happened?
Nothing happened.
Did they fire you?
No, no one fired me. I quit, okay? Just...
Why did you quit?
Do you want a list?
I hope you have another job waiting.
Look, I'll find something, okay? And it won't require a hairnet.
You told me that this was the only place hiring right now.
Look, I know you want me to work. It's just not going to be here, okay?
I don't want you to work, Lily. I need you to work.
Why are we broke? How did that happen?
You want me to give you a list? Lily, if you want to save the world, start with us.
Spent the night in Brooke McQueen's bedroom.
I did.
Right.
It wasn't exactly Cinemax. She was kind of unconscious.
Okay, help me out here. Where was I?
Entertaining Josh Ford. Care to share with the class? Oh, yeah.
No.
My lips are sealed.
Oh, look. Prince Pup Tent awaits.
Go. Hey.
Hey. I was this close to calling you this morning. I'm trying to translate this thing into French, and I'm doing a really cruddy job.
What is this?
It's a poem. Or lyrics, whatever. You sort of inspired me last night.
You wrote this?
Yeah. Well, sort of. And, not really. I copied it off one of my brother's albums.
Is this for you?
Well, I might get up the nerve to, give it to someone, so long as nobody posts it on the bulletin board first.
Yes.
Yeah. Oh, hey.
Hey. Oh. You're gonna have to check this out for me. They won't let me take anything out till I return that book on share.
Okay, I'll catch up with you later.
Okay. Hey.
My dad said that when he got home last night that you were sitting in our den reading. You told him I got sick on a bad falafel.
Yeah, I did. I didn't know.
No, it was smart. I mean, he would have totally called me if he knew the truth. I'll never do that one again. Made a complete idiot of myself.
Nah, you were just upset.
Yeah, but you didn't have to stay with me.
Yeah, I know. It was fun. Well, it wasn't fun for you.
No. It's okay. Thanks a lot, Harrison. Bye.
Are you sure that's the right tense?
Mm-hmm. Why are we translating this anyway?
I don't know. Everything just sounds better in French. It's more romantic.
Actually, I think it sounds pretty hot in English.
Yeah? You're right. Maybe I should just give it to her like this.
Maybe you should.
Any mortal achieves, she could still be humbled by something larger and more powerful.
What about boarding school in Switzerland?
I don't like that politics.
It's a neutral country.
There's no such thing.
Take these home.
Why? I hate relish.
Just take them. Take something.
Lily?
Coming.
Bye.
Did you really thank you and Josh?
Oh, please. He lives in a different universe. I mean, could you really see me talking football, watching Spawn, and translating sappy love songs into French? Yeah, I did.
Me too. I think my scalp's starting to bubble.
See, I like your haircut. Makes you look sweet. Like you were just hatched.
Nice cover.
Hey, look.
What?
The wind. It stopped.
It did.
You've been, but not too late. Chin up, child.